Yes.
You ready to be pwned? I'm gonna kill you.
Hello. We're here to give you some travel tips because in the last vlog, some people were asking how we traveled to Europe and did 3 weeks there for under 3,000 each. So we're here with coffee. This is Nat.
Hello.
We are going to share with you our travel tips. While we do that, we'll play a game. We have prepared photos from our trip. We've zoomed in a ton. We will take turns guessing the photos. Whoever gets it right, we'll share with you an insightful travel tip. Who would like to go first? Okay, and guessing or showing photo?
I think I have a great one to start it off.
How did you do that?
You're so rude.
I'm so rude.
Wendy is a bad person. She's a very bad person.
I'm gonna go with Rome.
No!
Wrong!
It's in Paris and we're eating crepes.
Do the revert thing.
So everyone, that's how you hold a fork and a napkin at the same time. Like this. Our first travel tip is very important. If you're traveling with a buddy, it's important to talk about whether or not you're into the touristy things or if you just want to chill.
Especially for Europe, it will tear you apart if one person only wants to do touristy things and the other person wants to do like local, cultural, feel the air things.
Or only museum.
Museum lover, museum hater, don't travel together. Mm-mm. This is the photo.
What is that even? What is this waffly knit material? This is in Madrid at the Way Hostel.
Okay. Incorrect.
Damn it!
It's us drinking in Barcelona.
It's a straw.
Sometimes it can feel like there's lots of places to go in one city. What we did was we Google mapped every single one and put stars on them. And that way you can visually see which ones are in the local areas and put them on the same day.
No point going from A-B-A-B.
Totally.
Round two.
Oh my god! Yeah! It's elbows.
What? I thought you wouldn't know that.
What else could it be?
I don't know, it looks funny.
Our legs are not that skinny.
I just need to win.
I'm gonna go with Barcelona.
Wrong.
No!
But close.
Oh no! Nat is also really fabulous in this photo, just like... like Armin face. And
I look like The Weeknd.
A fountain.
Something that I learned from a good friend. It's called the Google Images Test. Shout out James Lau. Say you want to visit the Palais Royal. So you Google it and then you see, oh, does it interest me? Yes? No? Also, one thing is you Google palace at night versus palace in the day. So then you can figure out, do I want to see it at night? Is it prettier in the day? Is,
oh, yeah,
are
we
any
haven't...
points going to be earned?
No points. Okay, well, maybe you'll get a point here. Where were these bikes?
Oh, I know where it is.
No way.
It's in, shoot, I can't remember. It's on the west side of Madrid where the guy with the shiny butt is.
Wow! Okay, east
1-0.
Side. But yes.
It's west. Oh, wait.
It was east because it was the day we went to the palace. He's leaning over a rail, but his butt is super shiny because everyone has rubbed just his butt. So it's like a golden butt.
Something that we did that was very, very helpful is to compare itineraries. We asked a bunch of our friends or what you did in Barcelona. Would you let us know what you thought was worth it, what wasn't worth it on your itinerary?
But if you listen to too many friends, you'll basically just end up having a trip that is a puzzle of your friends' trips. And it won't feel like yours. Ooh, that is my earring. Okay, there's green behind me. Oh, is this Paris? Is this Versailles?
Yes. I hate
ties. Is it the picture with me and the sunglasses?
Yes. Damn it! Yeah. How did you know? Like, just like that.
Because I know you like this photo.
That's cheating.
No,
that's cheating.
That's information that both of us knew. We kept our full itinerary on an Excel. It was on a Google Doc Excel. And then it's easy to move stuff around if you decide, let's do this on Wednesday instead of Tuesday, or easy to toss like a whole slew of random ideas below.
Yes.
And then move them up if you decide they are worthy.
Print two copies, bring it with you. You can alter it, check things off.
Yes.
It's really helpful.
I'm so happy to score a tad.
I'm not.
Where were these scary men?
There's a Rome flag.
No, that's an Italian flag.
I mean, that's what I meant.
I just realized that too. I was like, oh shoot, there's a flag. That narrows it down to two cities.
I think this is Italy.
Or think about it. Just because it has a flag doesn't mean it's in Italy.
Well, you were acting nervous that there was a flag, so
I'm
it's in Italy.
I'm actually so bad at lying. She's like, Italy, and I'm like...
It's Italy!
It's not Italy.
Damn it! It's in Italy,
it's
though.
It's in Rome. Campo di Fiori,
oh,
right?
Yes. Two, what? Yes. I can't wait to get to three. That's my number. Oh, okay, this one's super important, and I think we did a really good job of it, especially being slight control freaks. is to not have expectations to meet all of the things that you schedule in, mm-hmm. and to intentionally schedule in time to just roam around where you are. Because it's important to walk around and say, wow, that's really nice, I want to take a look at that, and not feel guilty. A lot of the times you'll run into people, or you'll just like find something on the internet the day before that you want to check out, and you want to be able to fit that in.
Oh, that's your hand.
How do you know?
White nails.
Okay.
Florence?
No, it's not Florence. It's in Italy though.
Oh, it's Rome?
Yep.
Show me.
This entrance to the Colosseum. This one is a follow-up of kind of leaving room for exploration. We downloaded a really excellent app called Triposo. It's very good.
Yeah.
So you can download for each city, say Florence, Rome, etc.
Yep.
And they have this cool feature where you can type in where you are. So say the Colosseum, and then they'll have an option listing things nearby.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, history lessons from Wendy.
It has all the Wikipedia articles for all the landmarks preloaded. So while we waited in line, we just became scholars. And then you don't have to pay for tour guides. It also was our map to tell us where we were, because it
has a GPS dot too.
Yeah.
I don't know how.
No Wi-Fi needed. Is it my turn to show you a thing?
Yes.
Oh no. Chance for you to gain points.
I'm loving this lead.
I'm so nervous.
I need to get to 3. It's my lucky number.
Where was this car?
Final answer. Barcelona.
Okay. Wrong.
Damn it.
It's our crepe!
Oh my gosh!
We went to this crepe place twice.
It was so good.
Yeah.
It was quite the trek, but very worth it.
When you travel to Europe, depending on where you fly to, the price can change a lot. So if you already know which ones you want to go to, you can figure out which one's the cheapest way to get in by using Google Flights. So we did Toronto to London. That one was like the most expensive.
I'm poor.
Yeah, help me.
I'm poor. What happens with Google Flights is you'll search for it. It'll show you on a map Toronto to London, but then all over the other major cities, it'll show you the exact same trip and how much it's gonna cost to go there. So when we zoomed out and looked at all our cities, Madrid was the cheapest place to start. We also saved money because we booked it in Black Friday to travel in June, which is like a very long time away.
Just commit to come on an adventure.
Yeah. What? All right, everything is very orange and it looks like knuckles. Is it Boqueria in Barcelona?
Yes! No! Yes! How?
Is it you and your food?
Oh!
Oh my gosh! So we both ended up choosing the photos with the giant sangria that we had. For places we stayed mostly at Airbnbs. We booked them in January, February-ish. And then we always compared hostel versus Airbnb to see which was better. Because sometimes hostel is more than Airbnb, when you're traveling with two people especially. You would just share a double bed, like that's fine. Whereas hostel is like single beds per person per night.
I personally prefer Airbnb, feels more like at home.
Yeah.
You can use the dishes.
Yes, here you go.
3 fingers here on the side corner.
You know, just chilling.
I'm gonna take a wild card guess.
She's going wild card.
I'm gonna say Paris.
Okay, incorrect, it's Florence.
I hate myself.
You being a peacock. Florence, we took time to sit on stairs, watch the sunset. A guy was playing live music.
People were bringing pizzas and beers. I tried to do a time lapse, it didn't really work out.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to live in the moment and not worry too much about capturing it.
Just do this.
Oh boy. I see a mole, it stuffs my arm.
I have moles.
Hey, looks kind of similar. Yeah. That floor is in Paris.
Wrong! 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 No. Wrong! It's you, and you look super jacked for some reason.
Only one carry-on each.
It makes it so much faster. You get off the plane and you go adventuring.
When you're in a different place, you don't need to waste time waiting for luggage.
Mm-hmm.
Just go! This is my last photo for you.
I see some toilet paper. This is perhaps the bed where we stayed at when we got stuck in Paris because people bombed the tunnel.
Oh yeah, no, they didn't bomb it. They barricaded it and lit fire. I mean, that's pretty close. Incorrect, this is not Paris.
Okay, let me guess again.
Is it in
London?
You get
Haley's bed.
Haley's bed. Okay, incorrect again.
Oh, it's Adam. It's my Spanish Adam.
Oh my gosh, it's Churro Man.
He actually looks like Adam Levine.
We were like, why is this guy selling churros?
Yeah, you could be modeling for Calvin Klein.
I know. Although, if that's his personal choice.
Then,
We respect.
You go.
Oh dear, cobblestone. Which leads me to believe this is Rome.
Damn it, it is! No! Does that mean you won?
Yeah.
No! No! Wait, don't you have one more?
Do I have to show you one more? I'll show you one more. Yes. All right, one more for Nat. She gets redemption.
The same photo!
Damn it. Me and my fruit, as usual. This is the glory tie moment. We could both have three, your favorite number.
No, I want to win. It's worse being tied than winning. My whole day is going to be ruined if I lose.
You can't say that while I'm choosing a photo. The fate of her day is in my hands. We're going to go with this one.
This wall looks super familiar. Oh, I know, I think. It's a weird European plug.
This is another tip. We brought two converters.
Hotel Girona?
Okay, her guess is Hotel Girona, which is in Barcelona.
You're wrong.
Okay.
I hate losing. I'm a loser.
No, you're
because
not.
I lost, that means I'm a loser.
It's the same bathroom.
No! I knew the wall looked familiar. I was like, I feel like I just saw this wall.
This is from when we landed in Madrid, right? All right, it's been a great game.
No.
Oh. Thanks, Nat, for playing.
Thanks, everyone, for witnessing my loss.
We will see you all next time. Thank you for joining us for coffee and pillows and blankets.
And games.
Hope you get to play some games with your friends sometime soon and relive
your trip memories.
Relive travel memories. All right. Bye.
Bye-bye.
We did it.
Wow, and it's only 10:50.
Hope you just got to-